guys. My name is Alexandra Roslin, and welcome back to my channel. I have recently acquired quite a few amount of books. Yeah. So what I think I'm gonna do is I think that I'm going to split them up into two separate hauls. Both will be probably pretty lengthy. There's a lot. So the reason I have so many books is because Christmas just came and so many of my family and friends all decided to get me gift cards to bookstores, to Amazon, which I was so thankful for. Hence, I have a lot. So, without further ado, let's just go ahead and get straight into it. By the way, these are not gonna be in any particular order at all. I don't know where to put these when I'm finished. Okay, so the first chunk of books might be kind of boring, but I'm really excited for them. So I've always wanted to take Shakespeare in college. It is the most coveted class ever. But it was always, always, always filled up. And the one time that I could sign up before anybody else, it was during the same time as a required elective, the year. I think it was down to the semester that I was graduating. So I could never take Shakespeare. So I've decided to just study Shakespeare myself. I started with getting 10 plays from Shakespeare. Now these aren't very cute editions of Shakespeare. However, they're really cool and let me show you why. So they're the No Fear editions and I hate that. I hate it. I feel like I'm reading Shakespeare for dummies or something. I'm just not well versed in old English. So sometimes when I'm reading Shakespeare, it just takes a second for me to try to understand what exactly I'm reading and interpret it correctly. And so this edition is super cool because on one side it has the original text and then on the other side it has like the layman's terms. For someone like me who has never studied Shakespeare but who has always wanted to study Shakespeare. So my goal for this year is actually to read 12 plays from Shakespeare, like one a month, and I wanna listen to the audio as well. So okay, these are all of the plays that I got. So I got Much Ado About Nothing, Romeo and Juliet, A Midsummer Night's Dream, Hamlet, Macbeth, As You Like It, Julius Caesar, The Tempest, Twelfth Night, and Othello. I don't know if you've been counting along with me, but that's 10. And the reason I only have 10 is because if there is a play that I decide on last minute, I wanted to give myself wiggle room to pick whatever else I wanted. But yeah, these are the ones that I've always wanted to read, and I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I don't know where to put this. Next, on Book Twitter, there was quite the commotion and excitement when it was announced that Netflix will be adopting the Grisha trilogy by Leigh Bardugo, and I'm pretty sure that's going to extend to like The Six of Crows and the Crooked Kingdom duology as well. And basically everybody was just talking about how much they hate some random girl named Mal. I have no clue what's going on. And then everybody also was like talking about how they wanted the Darkling to like make out with them. I don't know. Basically, I just felt really left out. And I was like, I wanna be in on the inside jokes too, guys. So I bought the whole series and I'm very excited about this. So I bought Shadow and Bone, Siege and Storm, and then I bought Ruin and Rising. So I don't know what the other two are about, but I'll go ahead and give you a quick synopsis for Shadow and Bone right here. So this book is about a girl named Alina who is an orphaned soldier in her country's army. And then one day when her troops are attacked, I don't think she's like the main person in charge, but like when they are attacked, she unleashes magic that she didn't know that she had. And then suddenly she's like swooped over to go and train with this elite army that are magical and she trains with the Darkling. I'm excited to see if the Darkling turns me on the way he turns on my fellow Twitter brethren and sistereth. Yeah. The next two books that I got are A Study in Charlotte and The Last of August. And these are both by Brittany Cavallaro. Yeah, Cavallaro. So I actually got these because one of my best friends on BookTube, Allie Corvair, loves this series, and she got me really, really excited about it. This book is about a boy named Jamie Watson who ends up going to a private school in Connecticut, and he meets Charlotte Holmes, who is the descendant of Sherlock Holmes. I think there's a guy who gets murdered from their class, and Charlotte and Jamie are essentially framed, and they have to clear their name. And that just sounds super cool to me. So I'm really, really, really excited to go ahead and read these two books. Next, I picked up a copy of The Love Interest, and this is by Cale Dietrich. And I am so excited about reading this book. I can't even tell you. Oh my gosh. So there are two spies, and they have to try to get this girl to fall in love with them. And I think that they're like rival spies. But here's the kicker. They are actually in love, but not with the girl. And even the thing, it says love kills. It does. The next book that I have is City of Ghosts by Victoria Schwab. This book is about a girl named Cass who almost drowns, and then I believe that she is revived back to life. But ever since the incident, she can now see ghosts. And coincidentally, her parents run a TV series all about finding and communicating with ghosts. I think it's actually something about like most haunted places in the world. And they end up going off to Edinburgh. Well, Cass meets somebody else who also shares her gift. Essentially, I think she discovers a city of ghosts. I don't know. The premise sounds really, really cool. And I love Edinburgh so much. Oh my gosh. I did my study abroad in Edinburgh for a little bit, and it's just like the best place in the entire world. I love it so much. I'll read anything with Edinburgh in it. I wanna like live in Edinburgh. I hate the stickers. Next, I have The Gilded Wolves, and this is by Roshani Chokshi. It's always this moment when I wish that I had remembered to check Google Translate. I hope I said that correctly. First of all, I am just such a fan of this cover. It looks so beautiful. Oh my goodness. But yeah, the premise sounds bitchin' as well. So let's talk about that. This book takes place in the 1800s and centers around our main protagonist named Severin. Severin is a treasure hunter, and when he is contacted by a mysterious society to help find treasure, he enlists the help of an unlikely bandit. Kind of sounds a little bit like Six of Crows, and I am all about it because apparently that's a great series. So yeah. Next we have a middle grade, and it is The Dream Way, and this is by Lisa, what? Papadimitriou. I know that's wrong. And this is by Lisa Papadimitriou. This is about a girl named Stella whose twin brother Cole is attacked mysteriously by a shadow creature on the way home from school. Well, one night, a talking mouse actually shows up into her room and takes her to Dream World, where she has to go and save her twin brother Cole. Sounds really cool, but to be honest, I bought it for the talking mouse because apparently that's something I'm really into. Next is a young adult, and it is They Both Die at the End by Adam Silvera. Spoiler, I hear they both die at the end. So in this particular world, you actually get a 24-hour notice when you are going to die the next day, which to be honest would be enough to give me a heart attack, so I would just die on the spot. However, in this said world, you can actually hook up with other people who are going to die so that you can have a friend who also knows the traumatic feelings that you are going through. It's a LGBT+ romance between two boys who are both going to die. Sounds beautiful and heartbreaking, and I can't wait to cry my eyes out to this. I'm gonna plan a whole day where I'm basically just going to be reading this and sobbing and probably drinking champagne. That sounds super great, actually. Next, I have a middle grade here, and it is actually a sequel, and it is The Secrets of Winter House by Ben Gutterson. Is it Gutterson? Yes, thank God. Okay. So I absolutely adored Winter House, which was the first book, and it came out in 2018. So I won't actually say what this book is about because it's the sequel and I don't want to spoil you for book one. So the first book, Winter House, is about an orphan named Elizabeth, and she is actually shipped off to this hotel one Christmas because her aunt and uncle don't really want her around for Christmas, which is really, really sad. While she's at this hotel, she discovers their massive library, and in it, a mysterious mysterious book of puzzles. The whole book is essentially a little bit of a cozy mystery for middle grade. You're trying to figure out the puzzles along with Elizabeth, and she may or may not be tied somehow to this mysterious hotel. It's really cute. I just thought it was like a cozy, cute little mystery. Yeah. So this is book two. We're not even halfway done. That's why I'm splitting this into two hauls. Wow. So we've got some more middle grade here. The next one is Monstrous Devices, and this is by Damon Love. Is it Damien or Damon? I'm not sure. Either way, it is a good name. So this is about a little boy named Alex who receives a mysterious package from his grandfather, and it is a robot. This robot somehow leads Alex into a world of magic, and that magic ends up leading him to learn about a magical family feud between him and another family that spans generation after generation, and it just sounds really cool. I don't think that I've ever heard of anything quite like this before, and I really gravitate towards new and original ideas, so I can't wait. Also, the cover is completely stunning. It's so pretty. I'm really excited about this book. Next, we have got Henry and Eva and the Castle on the Cliff, and this is by Andrea Ports. And look at how cute this cover is. I just think it's really cute. I'm such a sucker for illustrations. I really, really am. So this book is about a boy and a girl named Eva and Henry, and they are brother and sister. One day, their parents are mysteriously killed off. They are, I think one's an oceanographer and the other one, is the other one an explorer? Oh, an environmentalist. Okay, they die in a boating accident, and they are thus created orphans. Their uncle and their uncle's girlfriend comes to live with them, but then all of a sudden they start to get haunted by these ghosts that are telling them that it might not have been an actual accident that killed their parents. They have to kind of solve this mystery involving their parents and involving what happened, and it reminds me a little bit of A Series of Unfortunate Events. It sounds so creepy and good and exciting. I really want to try to get to this in the next month because it just sounds so good. The next one I have to share with you is The Wicked King by Holly Black, of course. So I am not going to tell you what this book is about because it's definitely going to spoil The Cruel Prince, and I don't want to spoil The Cruel Prince because this is the sequel to that book. But briefly, I will go ahead and tell you what The Cruel Prince is about after I sip my coffee. The Cruel Prince is about a girl named Jude who is kidnapped with her half-sister and her twin sister. Don't remember her twin sister's name. I don't like her twin sister, so who cares? And they are basically kidnapped by the fairy that murdered their mother. Lovely. And so these girls are raised in captivity, essentially, and they are raised as a fairy, or as the fae, I guess, but they're not really accepted because they're not fairies, they are humans. It's all about like the political intrigue and dynamics between the fae and them as humans and all of the like different things that are going on within this fae kingdom. Obviously, the Cruel Prince is in there as well. Don't really like him too much. I seem to be the only person on BookTube who like does not ship Jude and Cardin, but I don't really ship them. I do really enjoy the books though. The books are really compelling. It's one of those book series where you either like absolutely love the romance and they're a guilty pleasure, or you really can't stand the romance, but you enjoy the book so much that you keep reading. I don't really know a lot of people who don't enjoy the series. So I do recommend the series because whether you're on like team A or team B, you're gonna enjoy yourself, probably. Let's go ahead and do this bag next. So the next book that I have to share is The Brilliant Death, and this is by Amy Rose Capetta. So I heard about this book from Monica Kim, formerly known as She Might Be Monica. Apparently she is Monica. I love She Might Be Monica / Monica Kim. She's like one of my favorite booktubers ever. Her aesthetic is everything. If you have not seen her, she's a pastel dream, essentially. And she was talking about this book a couple months ago, so I went out and bought it. So before I tell you what it's about, let's just take a second. The cover is so completely stunning. I just cannot. But then also, the end papers, it's a map. I am such a sucker for maps. So this book is about a girl named Theodora, and she has the ability to turn people into objects, essentially. She also has the ability to become either a guy or go back to being a girl, which I think is so badass. She meets somebody named CeeLo, and CeeLo promises to really help her learn her abilities, I believe. And then one day when it is required that all families have to send in their son, she decides to go as a boy, as an actual boy, transformed as a man, kind of like Mulan. Oh my God.
Let's get down to business.
I'm excited about it. The next book is a book that I have heard lots and lots of really great things about, and that is Truly Devious, and this is by Maureen Johnson. So this book is about a private school in Vermont, and this was created by somebody who wanted to make education really fun. I think he said that he wanted to include games. Oh yeah, it says, a wonderful place full of riddles, twisted pathways, and gardens. A place, he said, where learning is a game. However, mysteriously, right after the school opened, his wife and daughter were kidnapped, and the kidnapper signed a pseudonym name, Truly Devious, as the only clue. Well, years and years later, now there is a girl named Stevie who is admitted into the school. And she, I thought somebody was walking behind me and that scared the shit out of me. This book is already freaking me out. And Stevie is convinced that she is going to finally solve what happened all those years ago. And so it sounds really cool. It sounds like a creepy, fun mystery. And to be honest, I'm a huge sucker for anything that happens in like a boarding school. I don't know why, it's one of those tropes where I'm just like a huge fan of, so yes. Next, I have a signed copy of Fake Blood, and this is by Whitney Gardner. This just sounds so cute. So this is about a boy who has a crush on a girl, and they are working on an assignment together. And he finds out that she likes vampires, that she is into vampires. So he decides to pretend to be a vampire to get her to fall for him. What he doesn't know, though, is that she actually isn't into vampires. She hunts vampires. And like, that is the most adorable premise ever. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Also, I really feel like the artwork of this is just so beautiful. Like the color palette, look at this. It's just gorgeous. So I'm really, really, really excited to read this. I can't wait, actually. Okay, cool. Okay, next we have yet again another recommendation from Monica Kim, and this is Marisha Pessel's Special Topics in Calamity Physics, and I am so excited for this book. So this is just about a girl named Blue who goes to this very elite smart school. I don't know, is it her? It just says an elite school, so I'm assuming it's maybe a high school, maybe it's a college, I'm not totally sure, but essentially she uses her power of intellect to kind of decipher what happens to one of her favorite teachers, who I believe ends up dying. This is a very, very vague synopsis because I feel like the synopsis on the back is kind of vague and I don't wanna convey the wrong message. Oh, there's a dog in front of me, cute. So I think this is gonna be the last book for this particular book haul, and then I will go ahead and start for the next book haul. So the last book for this book haul is The Odyssey by Homer, and this particular edition is translated by Emily Wilson. What does she look? Okay. My best friend in middle school's name was Emily Wilson, and I got very confused and also slightly jealous that she had written an entire book, but it's not her. Okay, so I wanted to get this because this is the very first Odyssey that has been translated by a woman, which is so incredible and so exciting. If you did not know, the Odyssey is essentially part two of the Iliad. It's what happens after the Trojan War. This is one of the oldest texts ever, technically by Homer, although a lot of people debate that it is written by a different person because stylistically speaking, like some of it isn't quite incoherent. Okay, so for the sake of this though, it's by Homer. Yes, and Emily does a really, really interesting job when she is translating this because she uses a little bit more of a feminist approach to how she interprets the text. She kind of like cleans up the language on how women were essentially like written about, which I think is really fascinating. I have not read this. I haven't even read the Iliad all the way through, which is sort of a travesty, I know. I definitely plan on reading Song of Achilles by Madeline Miller, which is one of my favorite books of all time. Honestly, it's beautiful. And every time I read it, I want to read the Iliad. So I'm going to reread that this year, and then hopefully that'll spark enough interest for me to pick up the Iliad. And then right after that, this book translated by Emily. And I cannot wait. And it's just stunning. Okay, you guys, that is it for book haul number one. I will have the next book haul up very, very soon. I hope you have a great day. Thank you so much for sticking around. Until next time, book lovers, keep your head in the clouds and your heart in a book, and I will talk to you later. Bye.